the other half is promoting it. And there's a lot of things you can do. There's things like stumble upon ads, which is 5 cents a visitor, I think. But Facebook advertising and both Reddit promoted things. I'm not even Reddit's promoted thing yet. But that's, I've heard good things about that. But there's ways to do that. But again, if you know the community really well, there's slightly more interesting things that you can do. If you target a really specific community, you could consider getting in touch with one or two of the big forums there. So get in touch with the site owner and see if you can sponsor a sticky page to stay right at the top of that forum for a week, advertising the thing that you've built for that community. And the last lesson is it's really, really useful to be able to react quickly, right? It's not quite good enough being able to just check the next day in Google Analytics that you've had a spike in traffic. It's much better to know there and then. And I use a thing called Chartbeat, which is real-time analytics, but it also lets you get an alert on your phone as soon as traffic spikes, which is really useful to be able to just jump in and kind of fuel the flame a bit if you want to kind of retweet whatever's happened or get involved. So you might be thinking, okay, well, that's great, but where do I start? Like, if you've not even got an idea of what to build, there is something you can do today, and that's just pick a community that's related to your industry. It doesn't have to be spot on, but pick a community and just really live in it. Follow their forums, follow their subreddits, follow interesting people or influential people on Twitter, and really get involved in it. Lurk at first, and then slowly get involved in it. And all of a sudden, you'll have these ideas as to what that community is going to like. You'll know how to promote it, and it'll just make life much, much easier. You'll be more likely to be successful. I'd also suggest encouraging somebody in your team to learn to code if you can. I don't mean hiring an outside dev that's really, really like an amazing dev. I just mean encouraging somebody to learn how to code at least those rough prototypes that they can launch. And there's some really cool things that you can use to learn if you're just learning to code. There's codeacademy.com, codeschool.com is really, really good. There's links for everything there. And railswithzombies.org is really, really cool, and it sounds interesting. It's cool. And finally, if you want to create an infographic or like a really researched, detailed blog post like that OKCupid page, get a feel for what sort of data you've got at your disposal. There's loads of places out there to get data, but just have a look through things like Google Internet Stats, World Bank data, which really has got a whole load of population data and stuff like that, and Google Public data, and get a feel for what sort of data you can get to build out those blog posts, those infographics. If you do have any questions, you can give me a shout at SharkSEO, and there's links for everything at sharkseo.com/brightonseo. Thanks.
Any questions? I'm going to go right up the back, so I'm coming, people. I'm coming. I'm upstairs, but any questions up here? Come on, I'm looking at you. Questions down here? Is everyone really keeping the coffee? Okay. So, I've got a question for you, Dave.
Okay.
I'm a media studies student, and I went to uni, so therefore I'm pretty rubbish at most things. But I like the idea of coding, but then similarly, I know, well actually, my time is short. I've got a relatively limited amount of time free to do things. I like the idea of learning those things, but actually, should I be improving where I'm good rather than starting something new from scratch?
It's a difficult one. I think you should just kind of do what you find interesting. It's much harder to learn to code if you don't really want to code. But the way I started was just by like half an hour at lunchtime, looking through things like Stack Exchange, following along with some of the Ruby on Rails tutorials. There's a book that's really, really good for Rails, by the way. It's called Why's Poignant Guide to Ruby. And it gets you really excited about Ruby, so I recommend that. But just take a little bit of time. It doesn't really need to take that long, maybe just half an hour a day, and just enjoy it, and it won't feel like work.
Fantastic. Have you got any other questions? Anyone come up with the right idea since tonight? Infographics that they've seen that's worked well, or things that they... Skepticism they might have around these kind of things. I've got a question over here.
I really like Hackerbuddy. I think I'm a member on it because Hackerbuddy was a while ago.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
What sort of things did you need to see that? What was the feedback like?
I emailed a few news. So I got covered by Mashable because of it, and which helped a bit. But it was being a part of Hacker News and getting it out there, which kind of really launched it. But also using it helped as well, because I, while other people were using it and getting